Welcome to the One Minute Apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
Frank, as you know, we've kind of done a positions series. We had the conditionalism, and you're representing kind of the traditionalism viewpoint as it relates to hell. Some people don't like to hear alternative views. They want it to be kind of right in here. In your opinion, as a Christian apologist, I mean, would you say, hey, Bobby, you know what? You really dropped the ball here. You know, you just need to represent this position. Or do you think that when it comes to hell, that's a major doctrinal dividing issue on whether annihilationism or traditionalism is true? Or do you think that we should be able to look at the different views and interact
with them? We have to look at the different views, and I think it enhances our capacity to learn more about our view, what we think is the right view, by interacting with brothers and sisters who may have an opposing view. Now, I'm not talking about a doctrinal issue and essential like the deity of Christ, sure, but these secondary issues, which are still important, but we're not going to divide over our eschatological view. We're not going to divide over which type of hell you think really is the true version of hell, because the gentleman you had on before believes in hell, right? He just thinks it's of a shorter duration than eternity. So that's something we can debate as Christians. And I think you should encourage these robust debates. There's things out there, books out there known as the Four Views books. I know you've seen those, where Christians of all different viewpoints come together and they debate, and you learn from one another doing that. So I encourage you to do that on these secondary issues. I think it's also consistent with Romans 14, where Paul says, don't divide over these disputable issues. Some of you are arguing over genealogies and these kind of things, or drinking wine or meat sacrificed to idols. Let your own convictions be your own convictions, and don't impose them on other people, on other Christians. Let's agree on what we agree on, the essentials, and these secondary issues we can dispute.